Thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to be reviewing the Snaptain E10 Folding Beginner Camera Drone. The Snaptain E10 that we have in this review is part of Snaptain's E-series of drones, which are budget-friendly and beginner-friendly non-GPS drones. In terms of packaging, you can see pretty simple. You have a nice graphic of the actual drone right on the box. A lot of the specs printed directly on there, and a little bit of warning information on the backside as well. We'll go ahead and take this out of the box and go over the specs. So retail price on this is $159.99. It uses a traditional quadcopter design, so it's really stable and compact. This has their 1080 FHD camera. So one of the differences between the E10 and E20 is that camera. You have 18-minute flight time, which is pretty nice, so you can fly this quite a bit. And it includes a spare battery, so you can actually keep flying by just swapping it out. It does have autonomous modes, which is kind of cool for a budget drone, so you can fly it automatically using trajectory, orbiting, and it has the auto land and launch with a single button. This is a non-GPS model though, so you don't have any GPS or return to home features. Instead, it just is designed for close range flight with a 150 mm transmission limit. In terms of what comes with it, you can see quite a bit. You have a really cool fabric carrying case, so everything fits in here. You have multiple pockets, and it even has straps and spare parts right inside. So what you get, obviously you have the drone itself, so little fabric holders here to keep the blades together. It is a very compact form factor. You can see it simply unfolds open. Then you have the controller, so a little remote control. Again, very compact with this fold-out design. You have the dual batteries here, so they include the spare battery with it. So you can keep one charged and then use another one with an 18-minute flight time for each battery. You have a fabric strap here, which is used for the bag. So if you want to put the strap on here, you can hold it a lot easier. You have blade guards. So if you're a beginner drone flyer and you just want to prevent any potential damage or breaking the blade, you can put these on and this will prevent it from damaging the blade and give you a little bit more protection for more close flights or when you're first learning. If you do break a blade, you don't have to worry. They actually include additional blades. So there's two different variations of blade, an A and a B. So you just have to look at what you have. They include all the additional hardware, so a little small bolts. We have a USB Type-C charging cable. And then we even have the spare blades on the inside as well. So you can see these include both the hardware and the individual blades, and they all come off individually. So you can see it comes in the set, which you can swap in for the whole piece by just undoing the bolts. Or you can just take off a single blade and swap it in place with the appropriate label. So it's B2 and this is an A1. So you just want to match up the one you need with the replacement part. There's also a little bit of instruction manual in here that'll help you get started, as well as website resources that'll help you pair it and set up the app. Now let's take a look at the weight of the drone setup. So just the drone by itself with the battery installed, that's only 189 grams, and that's on purpose. So they keep these really light to make sure they're classified just as toys and don't have additional flight restrictions. The remote, which has a rechargeable battery on the inside that you charge with a USB Type-C cable, that all together comes in at about 176 grams. So again, quite light. The Snaptain E10 has a compact quadcopter form factor that uses two blades on each of the four propellers. It's a very popular design and it's for a good reason. It's very compact, so you can see you can unfold it. You have to unfold the taller ones first and then unfold the back. And this gives a very stable flight. So you have the counter-rotating blades, so it really stays stable to hover and then to also steer. So really popular design. You have a front-mounted camera, a gray body here. And then see if I turn this on, you have multiple LEDs as well as these audio indicators. So you have blue LEDs on the front, that front-facing camera, which you can rotate all the way down. And then a larger status indicator on the rear. This is where the battery slides in. So to charge the battery, you actually have to pull it out and then charge it using the USB Type-C charging port directly on the battery itself. You get two batteries though, which is really nice. And then you can see really the only color on here are the blue tips. These are simple plastic blades. You have a blade guard, which can prevent it from crashing and make it a little bit easier when you're first learning. Otherwise, very simple design. You don't have LEDs on the bottom. There's one downside. So if you're right underneath it, it might be a little bit harder to see. And the only LEDs on the front and rear, again, are on the main body itself. If I hold this, I'll turn off. There's no battery indicator or anything else. You have to use the app for that. The remote is pretty simple, kind of a plastic construction. It feels a little bit generic with the Snaptain logo right on here. You have a fold-out design, so you can fold out the bottom. And it's actually pretty ergonomic despite the shape, so very easy to hold. Two joysticks that are spring-loaded. So one is for the pitch and yaw, so it'll pitch forward or side to side. And then you also have the rotation, so you can rotate left and right, or up and down for the altitude control. So if you combine the controls together, you can kind of tilt it, push forward, and do really tight corners. As far as the remote, it's pretty simple. You have a couple of buttons, single button launch and landing, so you can press that to hover it up, and press it again to bring it down to land it. Multiple speed settings, so you can make it more responsive or less responsive, depending on how you prefer it. The power button for the remote, a emergency stop feature. It also has a nice autonomous orbit mode, so if you press that, does it actually rotate around a fixed location, which gives you some kind of cool shots. And then you have a stunt button here as well, so this will do a flip. So when you press that and then the joystick, you can either flip it to a barrel roll on the side or front, depending on which direction you push the joystick. On the back side, you have a couple controls for the camera and video. So you have these little dials, which is kind of cool, so you can zoom in and out of the camera, and that'll adjust the zoom on the app. And then you also have the camera control, so you can, this is actually motorized, which is a cool feature, something you don't see in cheap drones. So this will actually rotate up and down, and you can control that directly from the remote in flight. You can take a photo and start the recording as well. On the back side of the remote, it almost looks like a antenna, but it's actually this little fold-out plastic prop. So see if I rotate this down. This is just a little prop for the remote, so you can see it just holds it up. This is a non-GPS drone again, which means you can't fly too far away or too fast. It will not return to home, and it's only designed for 2 mph wind, so if you take this too far up, it'll definitely get blown away and might be very hard to recover. So definitely a backyard drone. This is not for fancy stable shots, as there's no image stabilization either, so more for fun and to capture kind of unique angles at closer distances. Now let's do a little bit of flying with the drone. As you can see, you have a nice auto launch feature, so you hold the button down and it'll come up a couple feet and then hover. Then you have the two joysticks, so you can adjust the tilt and angle of the drone, as well as the altitude. So you can see the combination of them makes it very easy to fly. You can tilt it left and right, up and down. And then you can also do the altitude control and the pitch angle. So the combination of this lets you do really tight corners, and as you become more comfortable flying the drone, you can execute some harder to do maneuvers. The drone has a bunch of other features as well. So you can see here the remote has a couple labeled buttons. One of the interesting ones is the speed control. So you can actually adjust how responsive it is by adjusting it. There's three levels. So if you do one click, you can hear that one beep. Do it again, you'll hear the double beep, and you can see it's more responsive the higher you go. And you have to be careful with that. So once you're more comfortable with it, you can fly it in the higher speed and more responsive modes. But while you're training, you probably want to start with the more simple modes. Otherwise, the drone's really easy to fly. It's a quadcopter, so very stable. It is not very good in any type of wind situation because it's so lightweight. So you do want to watch out with that. In any type of wind, it just kind of drifts away. So you want to make sure you fly somewhere protected. This is not a cinematic drone either. It has a pretty simple 1080 camera on there, so you're not going to be able to capture very smooth images, and there's no image stabilization either. As a backyard drone, it's really fun though, so if you just want something to mess around with, become more comfortable flying with it, this is a nice drone. It's simple plastic construction as well, and you have this stunt mode that you just saw here. So you press that button, and depending on which direction you push the joystick, it'll execute a side flip or forward or backward flip, which is kind of nice. It's also really easy to land it, so once you're done flying, you can hit the auto land feature, and it'll bring it down to a nice smooth descent, Otherwise, there is an emergency mode if you hit the back two buttons. So if you're about to crash or something, you hit those and it'll kill the motor instantaneously. The other nice thing about this drone is you do have the motorized camera. So using that back button, you can see you can toggle it back and forth and adjust the angle on the fly. And this is a lot nicer than the really cheap drones, which have just mechanical notches. So you have to land those, adjust the angle, and then fly it again. With this one, you can adjust it mid-flight, and you even have the zoom option on the other side of the remote. Here's a little bit of flying footage directly from the drone. So if you put the memory card on the drone, you can capture this in the full 1080 resolution. As you can see, there is no image stabilization, so it's pretty jittery, hard to watch. So you're not going to be able to capture cinematic shots like the higher-end drones. Instead, it's more for fun, or if you want to capture a cool angle and just sort of hover in place. But with the camera adjustments, you can adjust the angle and use this for first-person perspective. Now let's take a look at the Snaptain app. This is available for both the E10 and the E20 drones, as they have the same features, except for the camera resolutions. You can see on the main page, you have a couple settings you can access, but the main purpose of the app is to go into the function view. Within this view, you get a live video stream, so you can actually do first-person perspective flying. And you have all the same features you have on the remote. So the auto launch, the emergency stop, camera angle, everything is here. The nice thing is when you adjust the camera angle, here you get some live feedback, so you can adjust the view, and then the zoom will affect what's visible on the actual app, but it doesn't affect what's on the memory card. So it's a nice way just to zoom in temporarily, and then you can always re-zoom it in if you capture the raw image data. Here you can see the warning that we're out of range. You have to be really careful with this. It is a small, light drone, so it can easily fly away. And once you become out of range, it'll just become unresponsive and drift away. So you definitely want to go run after it and make sure it doesn't fly off. But it's nice that you do get that warning. You can also notice on the app, on the bottom left, you have the camera and then the phone status on there. So you can actually see how much battery you have and what the transmission range is. So once you become really out of range, those bars will go down. And it's a good warning to make sure you stay within range. Otherwise, the app is fairly easy to use. It is a little bit confusing with all the icons. And again, it really duplicates most of the functionality. Some of the additional ones on the top right you can see is the headless mode. So with this one, it, regardless of the orientation of the drone, it's always going to fly toward you when you push back. And that's a nice beginner way to fly with it. So you don't really have to worry about the orientation. It's a little bit more intuitive regardless of which direction it's flying. It also has some basic autonomous modes where you can sort of draw a trajectory, but you actually have to turn off the remote. So it's a little bit confusing and not that useful. Now let's go over the pros and cons for the Snaptain E10 drone. What we like about it is that it's budget friendly. At $150, you get some of the more premium features, but it's still affordable enough to crash and not worry about. It's also easy to fly with an intuitive user interface. The remote has pretty much all the controls you need. And you also have an app to stream the video. It's also portable with a compact quadcopter design, so it's very easy to travel with and stable. The main negatives with this drone is the fact that there's no image stabilization, so the video is pretty jittery, so you can't capture the smooth kind of cinematic shots. Also, the battery status is only available on the app, so once the battery status becomes low, it becomes hard to fly, so it would have been nice if there was some LED indicator on the drone body itself. Taking everything into account would give the drone an 8.8 out of 10. It's a nice budget-friendly drone with some more premium features. Thanks for watching this review. Don't forget to like and subscribe. You can see more content from us on our website at thesweetcyclist.com, as well as follow us on Instagram at thesweetcyclists. This is The Sweet Cyclist reminding you to enjoy the ride.